So we get three species of aphids in cotton that are a problem. The main aphid species we're concerned with is cotton aphid. It's the species that will colonise the crop at the start of the season and can progressively develop through the season and become a problem. The other two species, cowpea aphid and green peach aphid, will tend to colonise the crop but then die off as the conditions get hotter. Cotton aphid can affect the crop in three main ways. The first is, and probably the thing we're most concerned about, is that as a byproduct of feeding, they're actually excreting a lot of sugars, and if that gets on the bowls, it causes contamination, which leads to problems later down in processing. They also affect photosynthesis of the crop, so the aphid feeding itself reduces photosynthesis, and we've done research which shows that that can actually reduce yield. And the third thing is that it's also a vector of cotton bunchy top disease, which the other two species aren't. Cotton aphid also has the capacity to increase rapidly if we knock out the beneficial populations. And in the past, our control strategies against aphids have actually selected for resistance. In Australia, cotton aphids reproduce asexually. So a female aphid gives birth to live young, which are exact clones of her. So you would think resistance couldn't develop. But what happens is the clones can actually mutate. So then, if a clone has mutated and developed resistance to an insecticide, any young that are produced by those females then will also carry that same resistance. So you end up with the whole population in the field or in the district being resistant. And that then becomes a real problem because it can render a product virtually ineffective against that pest.